guys, I'm at the Gaza bus stand, and the problem is there is no public transport available in the morning to go to either Kibbeh or Komik. So there are two buses, one towards Komik, which goes at 5, and again there is one bus which goes to Chicham at 5. So we might need to rent a bike to visit all the places. So bike here costs around ₹1,500 per day, and cost for the petrol will be extra, borne by us only. So I'm planning to rent a bike and visit all the places in one day and rest the next day in Gaza only. So that might be a better option.
So after a good amount of search, we found Om Homestay here to be the reasonable and decent option in Gaza to stay for backpackers like us. But if you can spend more, there are better options available as well.
And this is the only petrol pump which exists in Gaza, and this is the world's highest retail outlet. World's highest petrol pump, which is situated in Gaza at around 3,800 meters. So this is amazing. So guys, this is our first destination. We have arrived at Langza, and this is the famous Buddha statue at Langza. So this is even the last point of the village. So you can see Akash is standing at the cliff. There is no other point, and main household of the village are bit downhill. So this is the last and the farthest point of this particular village, and this Buddha Murti looks huge. So the distance from Gaza to Langza was around 20 kilometers, and it took around 40 minutes in bike. So the road is okay, quite motorable. So if it doesn't rain or doesn't snow, then it's very good to drive or ride. So finally, we have reached the world's highest village connected with motorable road. Basically, we are at Komik, which is the world's highest motorable village, and it also have world's highest homestay according to this, which is Jordan Inn.
And this should be the highest motorable monastery in the world as well. Basically, everything is highest over here, isn't it? And photography is not allowed inside the monastery, but right at the entrance you might get surprised by this stuffed life-size toy snow leopard. They say the skins are original though. So the monastery is situated at the highest point of the village, so basically you can see the entire village from this point, and you can actually count the number of houses with your fingers. Won't be more than 10-12.
So we are at the world's highest restaurant apparently, of course motorable, and we are having Darjeeling tea and different kinds of tea over here, and I'll show you the menu. And we are having
queue again,
but this time at the world's highest restaurant
with a good company like Fred.
Fred says hi. Fred says yo.
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 So we are here finally. Hacking Saurav's vlog. Look at this view, man. How are you feeling now?
This is fantastic. It's around 5 kilometers from Comic Village. And if you are in Comic Village, you should come to this point. You can see 260 degree view all around. And all snow-capped mountains. The total range is visible from this point. It's amazing. So finally, we have arrived Hikkim. So from the main road, you have to come down through this narrow patch to reach the village and the highest post office of the world. Parking hours 7 a.m. to 7:30 a.m. Then 1:30 p.m. to 4 p.m.
Oh. Also, don't miss the only cafe at the world's highest post office. This is an interesting point while coming down from Hikkim, which makes us realize how fast we have climbed an altitude so high after starting from Kaza. So right down there, that's Kaza. And next we'll be visiting Chichen Bridge. Asia's highest bridge, Chichen, is situated at 13,596 feet and connects Tibet and Chichen, thus reducing the entire journey by hours. We are here at Ki Monastery. This is our last destination for the day. And as the sun sets in the west, the passing light directly reflects in the monastery and it looks amazing. Probably one of the most iconic monasteries in India is the Ki Monastery. It hosts hundreds of lamas. I got a chance to chat with the main lama over here and he opened the door of the new monastery building for me to have a visit, although it was past the visiting hours. Not only he helped me take a tour in the entire monastery, he also invited me inside and served tea. It was a very nice feeling being a guest at Ki Monastery. Also, I got to know that due to maintenance purposes, the monastery guest house is temporarily closed for the outsiders.
recommend you to stay in other small villages in and around Kaza. That will be a better experience. And from here, my return journey starts. And until next time, stop dreaming, start traveling. Say goodbye from me. So, bye.